Little bit about your art camps. How have other artists influenced you? In what way have art camps influenced you, going with so many artists and not working in a studio, not working in this little tiny wall space? How is it different for you?
Art camp is a very important thing for an artist. Previously, when I used to go in art camps in other people who were organized, we used to paint in art camp. It was a great experience working with the 20 artists, and you see their different technique and this. It is good also and it is bad also in many ways. You know, because you get influenced with other artists. When you paint, you know, the things come there. So in one way, it was nice. Then secondly, when you used to sit in the evening, everybody used to talk about their work. And they used to fight also, you know, because if I say about my painting, all the, you are also an artist, you will say, oh, I can also paint, I am also a big artist, you are also a big artist. So, you know, sometimes it is healthy, sometimes it is not good. So, I started thought that I should organize some camps. So, I organized many camps. And the first format was that nobody will paint in art camp. And secondly, nobody will talk about art in the art camp. So no, nothing. It is only fun. Go to museum, enjoy, stay in a great place, see the things, historical things. Let's meet in the evening, have a good drink, enjoy. So that made such a great impact that you know every artist was very happy. And when they come back to the studio, they come with such a great memories. And they paint fantastic work. And the organizer is also very happy. And the artist is also very happy. Previously, it was like a class. It was like a class outdoor. And you know, from discipline to 10:30 to 1 o'clock you paint, then you have lunch, then you start again painting. And in 5 days, it is difficult to paint. You know. But you have to finish it. I feel that sometime it is good, but working in a studio is certainly a very important thing. Because we are not students, we are not doing landscape outside or copy work, whatever it is. So camp has helped because we come to know the nature of an artist. We come to know their technique. We come to know their behavior. I've heard about Lakshma God, but he stays in Hyderabad. I stay in Bombay. I don't know, when I was there with him for 10 days, it was such a great fun. You know, you come to know. This worked hard. And we always try that we take artists from all over the world, all over the center, you know, so that you know, you come to know an artist from Chennai, you come to know from Calcutta. That worked.
And you've done international art camps as well.
Actually, I've done mostly international art camps. I must have done more than 50 art camps all over the world with all the senior artists and junior artists and young artists. You know, I always mix and match things so that, you know, there is a fire of discussion also, and there's the humor also, and glamour also, everything, you know, you have to look after that. Like we went to, and my strength of the artist is never less than 40-50 artists. I had a camp in Switzerland, there were 56 artists. And it is very difficult to handle. And then when we went there, they say there is no coach for 56 artists. Maximum 52 they can adjust. So I said, what do I do? I can't leave them four elderly. So somehow they manage. I don't know how they find a coach and this thing. So sometimes these problems also come. But I really loved it. Art camp is very important for an artist to go because it gives a lot of experience and you helps you in painting also.
You have mentioned in one of your interviews that you have conversations with your canvas. So what are these conversations that you're having? Is the canvas talking back to you or
always you know, because if it does not react and if you don't get that vibration, you can't paint. It always says yes or no, or it always says it is not going, and that only you can understand, not other one. So it is the dialogue is very important with what you do.
Huh.
And that dialogue, we talk, you know, when we don't paint, we talk about the art. Huh. And we talk about the painting. Like, you know, if I'm sleeping, I always get a great dreams. You know, tomorrow I'll go and paint this, I'll paint that. When I come and I forget everything, you know, it is like that. The dialogue is important. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And when you're having this dialogue, sometimes does the dialogue stop and you leave the painting aside for a few months and come back to it later? Do you have such experiences?
Or? Actually, I never like my painting. Uh-huh. First thing.
Okay.
You know, when I paint, I do something and then I leave it for 10-15 days.
Huh.
I may like after that, you know.
Huh.
When I open again, sometimes I find interesting.
Okay.
Sometimes I find very boring.
Huh.
Like every day there's a fight in the studio.
Huh.
That I go in the evening, I love my painting, what
Achha.
Good work I have done. When I come in the morning, I feel what bad work I have done. I don't know why. Because it is you have your mind is subconsciously it's working.
Hmm.
When you are talking, you are sleeping, you know, every time you are thinking about your work.
Yeah.
What you have done.
Yeah.
It is not your past or the present. And when you come back and you feel that, you know, it is not justified what I was thinking or what I was assuming. So it's a great fight, it is always there. And it's a healthy fight. I feel it is important for
healthy.
An artist.
Yeah.
It's important for an artist to understand his work.
Yeah.
And I am never satisfied because I if you say that which is a good painting, I will not name it. It's so difficult. Maybe I don't know when it will come. But it is a process, you know, I can't do anything except painting, so I do painting and I'm enjoying it.
Yeah. And how long would you say it takes for you to finish a canvas, your regular canvas?
Well, it depends upon the work, you know.
Huh.
Sometimes I finish in 2 days,
huh.
Sometimes it takes months.
Okay.
Still it is not finished.
Huh.
It is, you know, it is, I don't know, it depends upon your mood also, it depends upon what is the, how you came from home, what was your experience at home, when you came here, are you happy or you are not happy, these all things matters.
Definitely.
And then, but I never feel that my painting is complete, I always feel it is incomplete, and I have to leave when I got bored, oh forget it, let us do it. It is like that.
Okay.
It is never complete because I don't know what I am painting.
Hmm.
If you know, it is not physics formula that you know you have solved it and everything is done.
Yeah.
It is a very vast journey. You don't know where to go, what to do.
Definitely.
So I feel it's never complete.
You're always doing something, always thinking about it.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Okay. Uncle, you are friends with one of the most well-known artists of the country. So, can you share a little bit about your friendships with them?
Actually, I like to make friends. Even my parents has a problem that he has got a lot of friends. And till date, you know, I like to make all friends.
Hmm.
Or different age, different profession, everything. And in the art field, you know, I have a lot of friends.
Hmm.
They have, I don't know why it is a quality or bad or good, but they always feel comfortable with me and I also feel very comfortable with them.
Huh.
And you name it, in India, I think most of the artists are very close to me, like Lakshma Gaur, Prabhakar Kolte, or Rameshwar Baruta. Like Mr. Baruta, you know, he was my teacher.
Okay.
And he taught me all this technique is done by him. He taught me.
The etching and
very humble man. Artists are always humble.
Yeah.
I have never seen any aggressive person.
Yeah.
They are very humble, soft, and they are nice to be friendly.
Yeah.
And I like all.
Yeah.
People are very. I am very fond of artists.
Yeah. So what was your experience like with Bruta uncle?
I was his student in College of Art.
Huh.
He was my teacher.
Huh.
He used to teach us portrait.
Okay.
And then after college, we used to work in Triveni.
Huh.
From 5 o'clock till 10 o'clock.
Achha.
There was director, always. And we used to, he is such a great friend, he sings very well. He jokes such a great, fantastic. He is a great person. He is my guru and till date I admire him.
Huh.
And I you know, I can never paint like him, maybe in my whole life, because he is ultimate.
So now that we have spoken so much about your art and your experimentation techniques, your texture, interest in texture, and how you've been exploring different medias and mediums, I want to know a little bit about if you are planning to experiment in the future. What does your future have in store for you? Have you planned that a little bit?
Well, not. You know, I'm always bored with my work, and I'm always in search of doing something different. I don't know what I will do if I will do the same thing. Maybe it can be repetition, maybe it cannot be. So you cannot say. It's a very difficult question for an artist to understand that where he has to stop the painting or what he's going to do tomorrow. It's a big question. I feel that, you know, whatever comes to you, whatever is there available, enjoy it and do it. That is the only way. That is the only way you can enjoy your work and you can be true with your work. That is.
So when you experiment, it just comes to you. You just have this urge. Mujhe abhi thoda badalna hai. I want to make it a little different.
No, intentionally you can't change. You know, you are sitting there, you sometimes come and see your equipment, you see your brushes, you see your knife, you see your colors, maybe something attracts, maybe something this thing. You try, sometimes you like it, sometimes you don't like it. Experiment is, you know, it is 80% is waste, but it works also.
It works, yeah.
So experiment is very important. Why not? Every time you cannot create great thing. Well, you can't, but experimentation is very important.
So it was really lovely talking to you about everything, your life. Thank you for sharing so much with me today. What would be your message for the younger generation, the new artists, the upcoming artists who are trying to make their mark in the art field?
Thank you, Ashna. I really enjoyed this interview and I'm very happy talking to you. And my advice to younger artists is that work hard, yaar. You have to work hard and you have to understand yourself. If you understand yourself, you understand your technique, then only things will be easy. Otherwise, it's a very difficult path. It is not that easy. Painting looks very easy, but it is very difficult. Because you don't know what you do. If you know, then things are easy. If you know, if you don't know, then what will you do? So you have to work hard. If you work hard, you have to be sincere and don't expect anything from anybody.